نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونثني عليه الخير كله. اللهم لك الحمد وكما تقول وخيرا واكبر مما نقول. نصلي ونسلم ونبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى اله واصحابه واتباعه الى يوم الدين. اما بعد, my dear respected elders and brothers, is there any sisters?
Yes, sir.
Sisters and mothers, I ask Allah Jalla Jalaluhu Al-Azim in this Mubarak night, this Mubarak time, to accept our a'mal, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And may Allah Jalla Jalaluhu give me the tawfiq to practice what I am saying to you. And may Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala give you the tawfiq to practice what you are hearing from me. Because what Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, what we say, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala will ask us about. And what we hear, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala will ask us about. What we see in the daily life of Muslims, in Ramadan, mashallah, the Muslims, they have so much himmat here, so much himma, so much strength to worship Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Salawat in the masjid. Quran, mashallah, at least everyone will finish the Quran once. Qiyamul layl, dhikr. But mashallah, when Shawwal comes, everything becomes, mashallah, nothing. Then the masjid empty, the Qiyamul layl, nothing. Even the optional fasting is nothing. And there is a sabab for that. And there is a treatment for that. Of course, in Ramadan, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam and the malaika, and they capture all the shayateen, the biggest shayateen, and they throw them in the ocean. And before the shayateen, 1 week of Ramadan, before they leave, every one of them, he has suitcase with him, and he comes to the responsibles of the Arabic TVs, Pakistani TVs, Hindi TVs, especially Muslim TVs, and they come to the responsible of those responsibles of the TVs and said, listen, brothers, I am going 1 month for Ramadan. I am being arrested for 1 month. So this is my amana. Take care of those people in Ramadan. That's why the TVs is full of, mashallah, movies, musalsalat. They, subhanallah, from morning to the next morning, they have movie after movie. And the people, unfortunately, they think when the movie is Arabic, an Arab movie means, mashallah, halal. So it does not mean if the movie from Arab means halal. It does not mean the music from Arab is halal. This is the problem, my brothers. So we have to be very careful. So the shaitan leaves, and those shayateen al-ins, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, شياطين الإنس والجن يوحي بعضهم إلى بعض زخرف القول غرورا. They whisper to each other. After Ramadan, الشيطان and his شياطين, they have been vacation for 1 month, but they are coming back to work. So they are coming back to work with himmat hay. So the first day of Eid, so many people, they lose all the reward of Qiyamul Layl, of Ramadan, of Siyam and Qiyam and Quran in the day of Eid. So many sisters, they come to Salat al-Eid with makeup, no hijab, and laughing, and mashallah, and they lose the 1 month of Ibadah in the first day of Shawwal. Couple hours of Shawwal, they lose everything. Because the shaitan will not leave us to go to Jannah easy. You know what's the duty of shaitan? If you ask this man, what's your duty? What do you do for a living? I am a doctor. I'm a teacher. I am a barber. Taxi driver. Ask the shaitan, what's your duty? He said, my duty to take as much as I can from Bani Adam to Jahannam with me. This is his duty. Day and night. And he does not, sometimes he does not sleep all night beside your head. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, when the insan sleeps, a shaitan ties 3 knots beside on the back of his neck. When he woke up, Immediately he wants to do some khair. Shaitan is sitting there. Ya Habibi, sleep, sleep. عليك نوما طويلا فرقد. So he said, no, my brother, sleep. No, you have long night. And long day tomorrow, so why you are waking up? So Rasulullah ﷺ, he said, when he remembered the name of Allah, one of the nuts untied, but still two nuts, is working on it. So if he makes the wudu, another two nuts, but still there is another nut still there. And if he prays to rak'at, all the nuts will be gone. But the shahid from this hadith that shaitan is standing all night, and he knows that he's going to Jahannam, and even though he's working so hard, he knows he's going to Jahannam. And we supposed to be, inshallah, going to Jannah, and what we are not even doing 10% of the shaitan and his group. We are not even making 10% of their efforts. Now, what's the way for me and for you to keep our Iman up? Especially after Ramadan. My brothers, this Ummah Marhumah, Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ummatul Marhumah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiplies the reward for them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the Jewish Christian and Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are their example like a man has three workers. He wants them to work during the day. So one of the workers work from Fajr to Dhuhr. And the other worker work from Dhuhr to Asr. Of course, from Fajr to Dhuhr is a long time. A lot of Amal. And from Dhuhr to Asr is less. But the best worker from Asr to Maghrib. He said that the Jewish, they work from, as the man work from Fajr to Dhuhr. And the Christian from Dhuhr to Asr, and Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they work from Asr to Maghrib. Then he compensate them the same thing. You are $50. Then the Jewish, they will say, Ya Rabb, we work more than them. Then Allah will ask him, did I give you your haqq? He said, yes. He said, okay, be quiet. ذَلِكَ فَضْلِ أُوْتِيهِ مَنْ أَشَىٰ. This is my father, I give it to whom I want. So Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if they make 49 sins, and make 5 hasanat, they will go to Jannah. Why? Because Allah multiplies it 10 times. 5 hasanat becomes 50, even though he made 49 sayyiat, and he makes only 5 hasanat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this ummah has khair too. Nuh alayhi salam stayed with his ummah 950 years. They were talking to him and he's talking to them 950 years. How many people they believe in him? How many people they became Muslimin? وَمَا آمَنَ مَعْهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. Very few. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he said the most authentic narration that only 12 people they became Muslimin. 12 people they became Muslimin in the duration of 950 years. I am very sure this masjid already accepted people, they became Muslimin more than 12 people. And those people they never heard, they never seen Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They never even seen the revelation coming. They never seen the Sahaba or Tabi'in or Atba'a Tabi'in. They didn't see anybody. So this Ummah has a speciality. So my brothers, if from my understanding, I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to give me the tawfiq to practice what I am saying to you. The first thing to keep your Iman level up, to have muhafaza ala salat al-jama'ah. To pray as much as you can with jama'ah. قال الله تعالى واركعوا مع الراكعين. Make ركوع with the راكعين. Who are راكعين? Those they pray in the masjid. And it is wajib. If you are close to the masjid, it is wajib to pray in the masjid. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم a man blind, he came to him and he said, Ya Rasulullah, in the Fajr time, there is so many animals in the Medina and I don't have guide to take me to the masjid. Do you give me permission to pray Fajr in my house? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, no problem, you pray in your house. When he reached the door, he called him back. He said, come. He said, he came. And he said, do you hear the adhan? He said, yes. He said, I have no permission to tell you, you have permission to stay in your house. Come and pray in the masjid. So the ulama, they said, if you hear the adhan, of course, the adhan, if somebody stands on the top of the masjid and he make adhan with loud voice, this area, anyone can hear it with no speaker, the salah in the masjid becomes wajib on him. But now we are far away, we drive 5-10 minutes, but at least it is sunnah mu'akkada to pray in the masjid. And my brothers, when you pray in the masjid behind the imam, when you are out of the salah, and all of us out of the salah, sometime of the salah, all of us out of the salah, believe me, when you say Allahu Akbar, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, my wife wants me to bring cucumber with me. Sahih or not sahih? It comes or does it come? It comes. Then when the Imam, mashallah, prays long and you are going now to the stop and shop and you are shopping. If you pray alone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes muhasada for your khushu'. If you are out of the salah, half of your salah is no reward. But if you are behind the imam and 2/3 of your salah outside, your salah is accepted because you are in jama'ah. The barakah of the jama'ah. So my brothers, when you come to pray behind the imam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept full salah from your salah. And look, there is so many rewards sometimes that people they are unaware of. Authentic ahadith. That I would like, inshallah, all of you to do it once in your life. To make ghusl yom al-jum'ah, the day of jum'ah, take ghusl in your house. And come to the masjid walking, not driving. Maybe I am 3 miles away from the masjid. Come walk. Take one day off. You know why? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, whosoever does that, Allah will write for him every step 1 year of ibadah. He made Qiyamul Layl and he fasted the days of that year. So if your house 2 miles away from the masjid, every step into the masjid in the day of Jum'ah walking, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will add to your a'mal 1 year of ibadah. How many steps from here to your house? How much concern we have about this now in our minds? Now we have, alhamdulillah, inshallah I will do it. Then after 2 hours, inshallah, I think I will do it. Then when we go to the house, I think it's difficult, but inshallah, I will tell my son to do it. But now let us look at it from this angle. Every step from your house to the masjid, $1,000. Huh? Huh? Mawlana, what did you say? Huh? Huh? Sahih? Mazlut or not mazlut? Wallahi, I will come. If every step. I will come every day. Not just once. Wallahi, every day I will come. I will come. MashaAllah, you are Zahideen, but I am not. I will come. Imagine every step $1,000. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every step 1 year of ibadah, صام نهارها وقام ليلها. He fasts the days of the year and he made Qiyam al-Layl. All Qiyam al-Layl accepted Siyam and Qiyam. Every step from here to your house, maybe 3,000 steps, 3,000 years of ibadah, accepted ibadah in your skin. Ya Ikhwan, can you imagine? By Allah al-Azim, you can't imagine. So Salat al-Jama'ah, when you come from your house, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من جاء للمسجد ليعلم خيرا أو ليتعلم خيرا أو يعلمه كتب له أجر حجة. Whosoever comes from his house to the masjid, his intention to learn some khair or to teach khair, Allah Azza wa Jal writes for him the reward of Hajj. Accepted Hajj. So what do you lose when you just have the intention? The intention is not heavy. Do you think you are carrying 5 kilo because of the intention? It's free. Just have the intention, inshallah, today I will learn something from Mawlana. Reward of Hajj. So, Salah al-Jama'ah. This is the first thing. If we make muhafal on it, inshallah, we keep our Iman. Second thing, my brothers, we should read Quran every day.
كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب لقد أنزلنا إليكم كتابا فيه ذكركم
In this kitab, ذكركم, عزكم, شرفكم Your honor in this kitab. So my brothers, every day you should read Quran. At least 2 pages. If you read after every salah 2 pages, you will finish the Quran in 2 months. 2 months, you will finish all the Quran. But wal'iyadu billah, we are those, even there is people who were complaining of Taraweeh is long. And they pray 8 rak'at and they stand outside the masjid. I pray 20 rak'at. I finish the juzur and sometimes more than juzur. And I finish the taraweeh, the witr and the dua. Then I go outside, I see them drinking coffee, talking. Yeah, it's very long salah. But it's not long talking outside. Why? Because of shaitan. He's still joking and laughing outside. He went out of the masjid after 8 rak'at. So my brothers, Quran. Al-Quran shifa. By Allah al-Azim, literally shifa. قال الله تعالى هو شفاء وننزل القرآن ما هو شفاء. There is one of the brothers in my masjid, and he's still alive. He was going to the doctor. The doctor gave him glasses. Then glasses, big glasses. Well, finally the doctor told him, listen, don't come back to me, that's it. Your sight is going to be done. You are losing your sight. Don't come back to me, Maskam. So he came. He told me, I start reading Quran from the Quran reading. Every day between 1 hour to 1.5 hours. Every day, for 1 year. He said, Alhamdulillah, I have seen my sight improving. Improving. He said, then finally I have no problem. I threw the glasses. He said, I went to my doctor after 1 year. I told him, check me. He checked me, he said, 6/6. What did you do? 20/20. What did you do? He said, I read the book of my own Jalla Jalaluhu. There is one sick brother, he was in Yale hospital. He is done. The doctor said, this man is done. The 5 brothers, they used to come around him and every day they read Quran about 45 minutes to 1 hour. After about 1 month, the brother, mashallah, became very good, alhamdulillah, and he went out to the hospital. Then the doctor, he said, hey, stop here, come here. he said, what? He said, I am atheist. But you guys, what you have done, is miracle. What you have done, he does not know. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يا إخوان والله القرآن عجيب. والله if you read the Quran with إخلاص by Allah العظيم. 3 people in my masjid, they have one of them brain cancer. One of them blood cancer, and one of them his sister in Sudan, and Allah cured 3 of them from the cancer because of the Quran. Wallahi. So the Quran, ya ikhwan, rahmah. When you read the Quran in your house, the shayateen runs away and the malaika comes. Why we have problems with our wives? Because our wives, our house is full of shayateen. No, we have women here, so be quiet. So there is a guy, you know, instead of writing, be aware, but no, it's the sister dialogue.
Be aware of the dog, you said, don't worry about the dog, but be aware of the wife.
That was kind of right option.
So my brothers, why we have problems sometimes even with our children? Because we enter the house of Muslims, mashallah, this picture here, and this idol here, this bird here, this elephant here, this donkey here, zebra here, mashallah. Of course. The malaika does not come to the house, has picture. Or even bill. Sometimes we have bills. You want to enter somebody's house, boom, like the kanisa, like the church. You should avoid that. These things, makruh in sharia. We should clean our houses. One pediatrician, children's doctor. He said, one man came to me and he said, my son has shaitan in him. He is jumping everywhere. So what should I do? I gave him all the medicine. It does not work. Wallahi, that doctor he made Hajj 4 years ago with me. He said, brother, do you have pictures in your house? He said, oh, of course. He said, listen to me. Take all the pictures. Take all the shapes, the idols. And they start reading the Quran in the house. He said, he came to me after 1 month and he said, Jazakallah khan, wallahi, my son became so calm like malaik. Ya ikhwan, the houses. So we should, Quran, read Quran. Ibn Amr ibn As radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, he said, Ya Rasulullah, how often should I finish the Quran? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, in 40 days. Then he said, Ya Rasulullah, utiqu akthar min dhalik. I can't do more than this. Alhamdulillah, I am young. If we are in his time, we'll say, Ya Rasulullah, it's too much for me. Can I make it in 2 months? We want discount. Always we want discount. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, okay, finish the Quran in 1 month. No, Ya Rasulullah, utiqu akthar min dhalik. He said, 20 days. No, Ya Rasulullah, more. Then he said, 10 days. Finish the Quran 10 days. No, Ya Rasulullah, I'm young. I will do more. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, finish the Quran in 3 days and don't finish it less than that. Means every day, 1/3 of the Quran. Then he said, how about the Siyam? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every month, 3 days. And Allah will give you the reward of the month because 10 times. Ya Rasulullah, I will do more than that. He said, every 20 days, 3 days. No, more than that. Every 10 days, no more than that. Then he said, Sum siyama Nabiyyullahi Dawood. Kana yasum yawman wa iftar yawman. Then fast like Nabiyyullah Dawood. He used to fast every other day. And by the way, Nuh alayhi salam, he fast all his life. 950 years he was fasting. 950 years he fast all of it. Now, after Ramadan, after the 6th of Shawwal, you know, the people, they say, next Ramadan, inshallah, I'll start fasting. Alhamdulillah, I done my job. 950 years was fasting. Allahu Akbar. And he took it all of it with him. So, he said, then, fast like Nabiullah Dawood, he used to fast every other day. So Abdullah ibn Amr al-As radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, I did not stop that. He used to finish every 3 days of Quran and every other day fasting. When he became old, he said, Laytani qabiltu bi rukhsati Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I wish that I accepted the permission of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he told me every month, 3 days. Now he became old, he cannot do it. But even though he left Rasulullah on something, he did not change until he met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was fasting every other day. He finished the Quran every 3 days. So yeah, ikhwan, those people, they have himmat. Azima. So we should, inshallah, from tonight, before you sleep, inshallah, 2 pages before you sleep. 2 pages after Fajr. 2 pages after Dhuhr, 2 pages after Asr. I guarantee you, you will finish every month half of the Quran, and the other month you finish the Quran. But our life, like our himmat, like the signal of our hearts, up and down, up and down, up and down. The third thing we should take care of to keep our iman, we should make dhikrullah in the morning, in the evening. فسبح بحمد ربك قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, سبح, make dhikr lillah. In the morning, in the evening. This is your soul's food. If you don't feed your soul will die. There is food for the soul, there is food for the body. Imagine you don't eat for 40 days, no food. What will happen? You cannot even walk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the same thing, we should feed our soul with dhikrullah. And the best dhikr what you should have always in your life, istighfar, salah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and tawheedullah. Any kind of istighfar. Astaghfirullah al-azim alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum wa atubu li. Astaghfirullah rabbi min kulli dhanbi wa atubu li. Any kind of istighfar. And it's not bid'ah to make it 100 times. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Sahih Muslim, أيها الناس استغفروا ربكم وتوبوا إليه فإني أستغفر الله وأتوب إليه في اليوم 70 مرة وفي رواية 100 مرة. So when you say I will make istighfar 100 times, not bid'ah, because Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said this number 2. So the ulama, they said if you make istighfar 100 in the morning, 100 in the evening, salah Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم 100 in the morning, 100 in the evening, Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, 100 in the morning, 100 in the evening. You are from al-dhakirin Allah kathira wal-dhakirat. You are from them. And by the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like bakr dhikr al-kabir. It does not like al-qaleel. Al-qaleel munafiq. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu dhkuru Allah dhikran kathira. Kathir. And he said about those they have qalil dhikr, they are munafiqeen. Innal munafiqeen yukhadi'un Allah wa huwa khadi'uhum wa idha qamu ila as-salati qamu kusala yura'una an-nas wa la yadhkurun Allah illa qalila. So munafiqeen, they remember Allah but qalil. And their sifat, when they stand up for salah, they stand with laziness. And by the way, look to yourself. Don't think, no, I am Abu Bakr Siddiq, I am Abu Khattab. No. Blame yourself and accuse yourself. Maybe you are munafiq. Maybe I am munafiq. Nasallahu alayhi wa sallam. Umar Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he came to Hudhayfa and he said, Ya Hudhayfa, I ask you by Allah al-Azim. Did Rasulullah s.a.w. mention my name among the munafiqeen? So Hasan al-Basri radiallahu anhu, he said, if you afraid of the nifaq, this is a sign of ikhlas. If you feel safe of the nifaq, this is a sign of nifaq. So look at yourself. If they said salah, if you say salah, if you stand with laziness, this is sifat of munafiqin. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى. You see, if you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala little, this is a sign of munafiqin. That's Allah rahman wa ta'ala. So dhikrullah, my brothers. Dhikr lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After every salah, there is dhikr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whosoever, 70% of the masajid, with all the respect to my brothers from Hind, Pakistan, and that area, there is something I want to convey it to you, because it bothers me, wallahi. When the imam, after salam alayhi wa sallam, some imam says, Allahumma salli ala sallam Muhammad, and everybody raises his hand, sallallahu wa sallam, barak as Muhammad, is that the Shaykh tells him, Jazakumullah khair, you are done, go to your work. And no one of them recite Ayatul Kursi or Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar, no one does it. After Mawlana said, wa sallallahu, everybody says, Jazakumullah khair, they start Sunnah. And it's not the Sunnah of Rasulullah. Rasulullah said, whosoever recite Ayatul Kursi after every Salah, nothing between him and the Jannah but the death. When he dies, he goes to Jannah. The second hadith, Rasulullah said, whosoever says after every salah, Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 33 times. This is 99. And he finished, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu, lahul mulk wa lahul hamdu wa la kulli shay'in qadir. This is 100. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase all his sins, even his sins like the foam of the sea. You see? But sometimes we, because we get used to this in our country, after salam, dua. And the problem sometimes, if you don't do it, the people, they come to you and say, Mawlana, why you not make dua? Wallahi, one Jum'ah, a man came to me and said, why you not make dua? I said, excuse me. He said, why you not make dua? I said, when I should make dua? He said, after Jum'ah. I said, go to all the Mawlanas and bring me one hadith that Rasulullah said, after Jum'ah, he rose his hand and made dua. One hadith. I don't say it's bid'ah, it's halal to do it. But to make it as obligatory, you have to do it. If you don't do it, you are making drunk. This is bid'ah now. Because you are bringing to the deen something. Rasulullah ﷺ did not emphasize or Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman or Ali radiallahu ta'ala. But if the Imam raises the hand and make dua, is halal, sunnah, no doubt about this. It's khair. But ya ikhwan, give some time for the people to make dhikr lillah and teach them. Because sometimes maybe the Imam will tell you, if I give them some time, they will not catch the dua, they will not do dhikr. They will not catch any one of them. No, give them and tell them, brothers, this is the time.